Good morning, with you, Miss Yasmin, science teacher. We are going to cover today Unit 3, Lesson 2, Reproductive in Men. Slide number 2. In this lesson, we will study the male reproductive system, the female reproductive system, the structure of the ovum, fertilization, and genital system disease. Slide number 3. Here we can see the male reproductive organ. We can see the testis, surrounded by scrotal sac. Above the testis, this is epididymis. And we can see the penis. Inside it, there is a urethra. And there is a urinary opening. Here we can see the vas deferens. And we can see the urinary bladder. And here we have seminal vesicle, prostate gland, and Cowper gland. All of them are called genital gland. Slide number 4. First, the two testes. They are two glands of oval shape. They lay outside the body in a sac which is called scrotal sac. What is the function of the testes? It produces sperms. And what is the function of the scrotal sac? It keeps the temperature of the testes 2 degrees below the normal temperature. So here, the two glands of oval shape found inside scrotal sac are the two testes. What is the function of the scrotal sac? Keep the temperature of the testes 2 degrees below the normal temperature. Here we have the sign of puberty, growth of the hair, harshness of the voice, and the growth of bones and muscles. Slide number 5. Here we can see the vas deferens. Testes are connected with group of tubes called epididymis, which form single tube called vas deferens. What is the function of the vas deferens? It stores the sperm until it comes out of the human body. What is the function of the vas deferens? It transfers the sperm from testes to the urethra. So here the function of epididymis stores the sperm and the vas deferens transfers the sperm. Slide number 6. The genital gland. There are three glands: seminal vesicle, prostate gland, and Cowper gland. And the function of the genital gland: number 1, they feed the sperm. Number 2, neutralize the acidity of the urethra. Here, it neutralizes the acidity of urethra. Give reason because it alkaline fluid. 4, penis. The semen and the urine go out of the body through the penis, not in the same time. Not in the same time. Slide number 7. Here we have the female reproductive system. It consists of vagina, ovary, and fallopian tube. Here in the middle, we can see the uterus. Slide number 8. Here the two ovaries are two glands, have a size peeled almond. What is the function? It produces the ova. Also, production of the sex hormone, which are estrogen and progesterone. The sign of puberty in the female. Here we have 4 signs of puberty. Number 1, growth of the hair. Number 2, softness of the voice. And here we have the menstrual cycle every 28 days and the growth of the breast. Slide number 9. The two fallopian tube. The inner wall of the fallopian tube lined with cilia. What is the function? It receives the mature ovum and directs it toward the uterus. Here we can see the sperm pass to the fallopian tube. After the sperm mate with the ova, it fertilizes and it goes once again to the uterus. Number 10. The uterus. It is a hollow which is responsible pear-shaped organ. It has a muscular wall that can expand as the fetus grows. Here it forms placenta and umbilical cord. Number 4, the vagina. It is a muscular tube that expands during the labor and delivery the baby. Here, slide number 11. The structure of the sperm and the ovum. Here we can see comparison between ovum and sperm. The sperm, it is small in size, but the ovum is large in size. The sperm is mobile, it moves, and the ovum is static. Here we can see it consists of tail, middle, and head. Here we can see the head contains half number of chromosomes. And the ovum consists of cell membrane, cytoplasm, and nucleus. Also, the nucleus contains half number of chromosomes. Slide number 12. Fertilization and embryo formation. Here, the fertilization, it is a fission of male gamete sperm with female gamete to form the zygote or the fertilized egg. So millions of sperm can enter the egg, but one only can penetrate it to form the zygote. How does the fertilization take place? The head of the sperm secrete enzyme to dissolve the cellular membrane of the ovum. Only one sperm can penetrate. So the ovum surrounds itself with membranes that prevent the penetration of any other sperm. Slide number 13. Here we can see the nucleus of the sperm with nucleus of the ovum to form the zygote. The zygote here divided and continues to grow formation of the embryo. Slide number 14. Here we have genital system disease. Here we are going to take some disease. Number one, species. Here we can see the microbe spherical shaped bacteria. Symptoms, high temperature and severe acute pain in the lower. And we can see it takes from period 1 to 4 days. The incubation period, it is a period between the beginning of the infection and the appearance of the symptoms of the disease. So what it is meant by incubation period? It is a period between the beginning of the infection and the appearance of the symptoms. Slide number 15. Here we have syphilis, spiral-shaped bacteria. The symptoms appear of dark press-colored rashes on the back and head of the patient. So it takes period from 2 to 3 weeks. If the patient is not treated, lead to tumors or brain damage. Slide number 16. Give reason. Number one, the head of the sperm secrete enzyme. Why the head of the sperm secrete that enzyme? To dissolve the cell membrane of the ovum and can penetrate it easy. Number two, the inner wall of the fallopian tube is cilia or contains some cilia to direct the mature ovum toward the uterus. Here, the seminal fluid is alkaline fluid. Why it is alkaline fluid? To neutralize the acidity of the urethra. Here we have mentioned the function, the testis. What is the function of the testis? It produces the sperm and the testosterone hormone. And the ovary produces the ova, and it also produces two hormones, which are estrogen and progesterone. Thank you.